Good afternoon, and welcome to the 49th West Burlington Arnold High School graduation ceremony for the class of 2012. It is a pleasure to have the family, friends, members of the faculty, school board members, and of course the honored graduates present to share in this important day. On behalf of the West Burlington faculty, I'd like to congratulate the graduating class of 2012. It is a significant milestone and very exciting day for you, your families, and your friends. As you leave West Burlington, I challenge you to explore the vast opportunities that lie before you. There is much potential and promise in almost every one of you, all of you. Some of you graduates already have chosen your path for the future, some of you have not. But don't rush into your life's work. Discover what you really like and what you really want to do. Find your true interests and pursue them without reservation or regret. I urge you to remember those loved ones and people in your lives that have taught you life lessons and given you those experiences that have brought you to where you are today. As I was preparing for today, I was reminded of a quote: "Make the most of yourself, for that is all there is of you. All that stands between you and where you want to be is you. Have the courage to follow your heart and your intuition." Graduates of 2012, today is the end of a journey, but the beginning of another one. I challenge you to stand up for your dreams and work every day to make them a reality. I wish the class of 2012 the very best and good luck in all their endeavors. Starting off today's ceremony, we have a special vocal presentation that is a combined effort by the seniors of the graduating class of 2012 and the West Burlington Arnold High School Concert Choir. Under the direction of Mrs. Brooke Smith, the seniors and the concert choir will perform For Good.
Like a comet pulled from orbit as it passes the sun.
Thank you, Mrs. Smith, seniors, and concert choir. As customary practice here at West Burlington, the class of 2012 has selected two of their own to deliver the traditional senior address. A special multimedia tribute to honor the class of 2012 will accompany that senior address. Please join me in welcoming two outstanding representatives of class of 2012, Ms. Kaylee Wagner and Mr. Andrew Crooks.
Welcome, parents, grandparents, family members, teachers, and fellow seniors. We would just like to say,
we did it.
We've made it through six principals, through flipping cards, tickets, and demerits, and through 13 years of friendship.
As we sat down to write this speech, we realized that our class is, well, indefinable.
In order to better define our class, we looked up the word define in the dictionary. It is a verb that means to explain or identify the nature or essential qualities of.
Yep, we're indefinable. How can you define a class of a nose picker, a male stripper, and a writer?
To the person who can't stop smiling, to nail biters and wedgie pickers.
And let's not forget about the annoying sound makers, the early risers, and the late arrivers.
Lately, we can't even describe ourselves as Americans.
We've got Scottish people, British people, Australian people, and Zborat people.
And to all those who don't understand what we are talking about, the senior boys have picked up an accent and spread it throughout the school, and we can't stop talking in it once we get started.
So here we are, still looking at a class who is indefinable, which at first we thought was a bad thing, but we've come to realize that the freedom we have of not having boundaries have made us who we are.
The experiences we have had together have helped to describe us as a whole. We went from being forced to take naps in kindergarten to sneaking naps in the cozy corner of the library.
We have gone from running each other into walls on scooters to driving getaway cars.
We all remember competing against each other to try and win a lunch with Mr. Magel and, of course, his puppets, Can Do and Will Do.
Now we're competing for sore cards and the free Gatorade at lunch.
Remember those pep rallies we had in elementary school? It's hard to believe this year we are the ones putting on the pep rallies for the kids at the elementary.
We put those high-quality dance moves, like the jive we learned in Mrs. Vetter's class, to good use when we took a trip to perform in Florida for band and choir our freshman year.
We've also had our fair share of a rebellious streak, from breaking noses to putting people in lockers.
And our pranks we've pulled on teachers, like shooting Miss Hursting with a rubber band, attempting to put dog poop on Mr. Mord's car, and prank calling Mr. Moffitt.
And I don't think we could ever forget 8th grade Spanish with Mr. Malagon and the countless pranks we pulled on him. These past couple years have been filled with memories like gym class wipeouts and the hypnotized Michael Jackson.
How are them legs feeling, Zeke?
We also had special visits from the Green Men during volleyball games,
which encouraged everyone else to start dressing up in ridiculous costumes for the games.
And that time when the entire crowd was ejected from a baseball game, or the fight during the basketball game.
But there have been some good, positive things during sports.
Like both boys and girls track teams winning the conference.
The library has been a very eventful place this year.
We had Cassidy getting kicked out every day as soon as she stepped through the door.
Miss Guyan.
While Zeke was sitting on the couch.
Legs on the table.
An iPad in hand.
Wandering the halls and playing tennis with flip-flops in room 255 was also how us seniors spent our time.
There was also a time or two when we played volleyball with a Kleenex box. And during March Madness, we didn't try hardly at all or plan anything, and we won the pizza party.
Thank you to the Cupid Shuffle.
Over these few years, we have discovered a reoccurring trait in us.
Procrastination.
Remember that Falcon Focus we never had this year?
Or the speech we wrote yesterday.
And putting all those homecoming floats together the day before the parades.
Or how about that CPR certification we had to have before we graduated?
Regardless of this trait we have in common, we are all still 49 different, indefinable individual people.
As we sit here today, we have to realize that tomorrow we start our future. Being who we are, we must set out with endless boundaries.
When we go out into the world, we will not let society define us.
But we will define society.
Although we all will take different paths,
we'll never be alone. Our memories will never leave us. And
we'll always remember the class of 2012.
Gone. Tell everybody I'm on my way. New friends and new places to see. With blue skies ahead, yes, I'm on my way. And there's nowhere else that I'd rather be. Step I take with the sun beating down. Yes, I'm on my way, and I can't keep this smile off my face. 'Cause there's nothing like seeing each other again, no matter what the distance between. And the stories that we tell will make you smile.
Thank you, Kaylee, Andrew, and the slideshow representatives. At this time, I'd like to recognize members of the class of 2012 who are the recipients of various honors and awards. Many other scholarships and award winners are listed on the graduation program. We will begin with this by recognition of those students who have been honored as members of the Silver Cord Society. To qualify for this recognition, students were required to complete a minimum of 400 hours of volunteer service. The symbol of the student's involvement is wearing a silver cord with their graduation robes. The following students have contributed countless hours to the betterment of their church, school, and community. At this time, I'd like the following silver cord recipients from the class of 2012 to be recognized for this outstanding accomplishment. When I call your name, please stand and be recognized. Andrew Crooks. Kaylin Parker. And Kaylee Wagoner. Next would be the acknowledgement of the Academic Excellence Award. This award goes to students who are ranked in the top 10% of their graduating class. I'd like these students to stand and remain standing until all have been called. Jamie Johnson. Daly Levine. Will Reckhammer. Kaylee Wagoner. And Caitlin Walker. Now I'd like to recognize the salutatorian for the class of 2012. This student has finished her high school career with the second highest grade point average in the class after 8 semesters of coursework. Would Miss Jamie Johnson please come forward? Next, I'd like to introduce the valedictorian for the class of 2012. The student has finished her career ranked with a perfect 4.0. Would Ms. Kaylee Wagoner please come forward? Finally is the awarding of the Walter E. Arnold Memorial Scholarship. This scholarship is awarded annually to a deserving senior in honor of longtime educator of the West Burlington School District. Mr. Arnold spent his entire career at West Burlington as a classroom teacher and eventually served as superintendent, a position he held at the time of his death in 1971. In honor of his commitment to education, a memorial fund was established. And interest from that fund is provided every year for scholarships of selected graduating seniors. This year's recipient of the Walter E. Arnold Memorial Scholarship is Ms. Kaylee Wagoner. Please come forward.
I get the fun part. President Young, members of the West Burlington Independent School District Board of Education, I'm pleased to report that all of our students have met the requirements as outlined by board policy. So it is my great pleasure to report that I'm going to present the graduating class for West Burlington Independent School District of 2012.
Would the first row of graduates please stand and approach the stage? Dinara Obeldanova. Carrie Ashley Albert. Bradley Michael Barnett. Courtney Ann Brown. Colton Caleb Campbell. Jessica Ellen Casey. Cody Allen Cheely. Andrew James Crooks. Kyle David Desjardins. Ashley Marie Graham. Cassidy Peyton Guyon. Karina Lynn Hand. Trevor John Hostetter. Carissa Ellen Houston. Jamie Lee Johnson. Marcus Allen Jones. Hedenau Kinjo. Daily Lou Levine. Ross Daniel Lee. Caleb Joseph McDowell. Brock Austin Michelson. Allison Paige Milligan. Courtney Luann Moore. Kennedy Christine Moranic. Would the second row of graduates please stand and approach the stage? Zeke Dalton Murphy. Kaylin Lee Parker. Kelsey Ray Prickett. Will Tyler Reckhammer. Connor James Robertson. Jill Nicole Rokas. Colton Lee Cepeda. Emma K. Shipley. Samantha Sue Ann Showalter. Emily Marie Siefkin. Jessica Nicole Spracklin. Kazua Tirada. Oslyn Brenna Wagner. Haley Brooke Wagner. Kaylee Morgan Wagoner. Cade Michael Walker. Caitlin Brianne Walker. Danielle Ariel Wall. Dominique Catrice Weldon. Trevor John White. Lauren K. Williams. Whitney Suzanne Woodside. Who knew that Drake was so emotional? Drake Anthony Woodsmall. Jacob John Zachmeyer. They've been tears since last Wednesday, so this is nothing. In closing today's ceremony, and on behalf of the staff, the administration, you can sit. The Board of Education for the West Burlington Independent School District, I would like to congratulate the class of 2012. Family, friends, and guests, you're invited to greet the graduates as they are assembled in the receiving line at the sides of the gymnasium at the end of the ceremony. Graduates, will you please stand? Turn and face the audience. You may now move your tassel from the left side of your cap to the right, symbolizing the recognition of your status as high school graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, I proudly present to you the West Burlington High School graduated class of 2012. Thank you for coming, and feel free to mingle with the graduates.